What is a 51% attack? A decentralized, permissionless cryptocurrency depends on the majority of the users in the system having honest intentions and participating in the protocol. That might sound scary, but conversely, this means that if a cryptocurrency can't be 51% attacked, it would be by definition permissioned and centralized. What constitutes a 51% attack is simply that a person or a group of people somehow gets the majority of the resources on the network. In a proof-of-work system like Bitcoin, the resources are computing power. If you control more than 50% of the network's mining hash rate, you are able to create the majority of blocks and thus successfully perform an attack. In a proof-of-stake system like Cardano, it's all about stake. You have to own more than 50% of the staked ADA to have the chance to create the majority of blocks and successfully perform an attack. An attacker would be able to prevent new transactions from gaining confirmations, to slow down, or in some cases, even completely prevent payments between some users. They would also be able to reverse some, not too old transactions, to double spend coins. However, they couldn't change transactions that occurred in the distant past. Apart from double spending, they also couldn't create coins out of thin air that never belonged to them. It would also be impossible for them to prevent transactions from being created. Usually, the most attractive thing for an attacker is the so-called double spend attack. To understand how double spending is even possible, you have to know that blockchains can fork for a short time, if there is a disagreement in the network. This can happen for a number of reasons. Suddenly, there are two chains with different blocks and different transactions, and the network has to decide which one is the right chain. In a proof-of-work system, those forks are simply resolved by a rule that selects the longest chain. Because the longest chain contains the most work, it was the most difficult to create, and thus has to be the right chain. Cardano resolves such forks by a somewhat similar rule. Without going into too much detail, the network selects the most dense chain, which is not necessarily the longest one. The important thing to note here is that if you are the one that creates the majority of blocks, it is likely that you can create the longest or the most dense chain, and therefore get selected by the rule. Here is one example of what a double spending attack might look like. The attacker forks the chain into an honest and a malicious chain. Then, he immediately spends the coins on the honest chain for fiat on an exchange. The attacker will then attempt to catch up with the blocks on the honest chain and create the longest or densest chain. If the attack is successful, the network will select the malicious chain as the correct one, and the spent coins are placed back in the attacker's wallet. Thank you for watching.